Eilen nähtiin uusintana Frank Pappa Show, siis se, joka edustaa kolmosta Montrealin kultaisen ruusun kisassa. Ja tänään nähdään sitten uusina uusintana, ihan kohta puolella.
Jos et sä soita, sut tahdon pois jo mielestä.
Ohjelma nähdään aina keskiviikkoisin kolmoskanavalla ja perjantaisin MTV:n ykköskanavalla. Näin jokainen suomalainen ehtii varmasti ruudun ääreen.
This is the story of a man who became a legend in his lifetime. During his career, 54-year-old Frank Nelson Papa has always been on the scene when history was in the making, perhaps more often than anyone else in the history of the media. His life story is part of newscasting history at its most glorious. As a young student, Frank Papa reported the Russian tanks rolling into Hungary. In 59, he witnessed Fidel Castro take power in Cuba. And the following year, he reported live from the inauguration of President Kennedy. In November 63, we meet Frank Papa at the center of the chaos caused by the assassination of the same man, JFK. During 1964 to 68, he was a war correspondent in Vietnam, revealing to the world the bizarre face of the war. The last time he was seen in public was backstage in Woodstock. That same year, Frank Papa was chosen Man of the Year, 21 years before Ted Turner. Soon after this, he left the news world as a protest against censorship of his journalistic work and retired to his hacienda in a certain Latin American country where he became an environmental activist. He was out of the limelight for 20 years until he was persuaded back to the business again with a record-breaking deal. He chose to make his comeback in Finland, because he wanted to start from less than zero. During his entire career, he has followed one star, his legendary motto. The news can be good or bad, but every day I shall bring you the news, the truth. That is what you will get today, the truth.
Recorded live every Friday, Frank Papa Show. Written by the whole world. And here's Frank.
Hello, I'm Frank Papa. It's Friday night and it's news time! I shall give you the truth! But we'll start with a leg of numbers. The Finnish government will give money to all winners. And the numbers are 3, 9, 1, 6, 6, 7. That makes almost 400,000 unemployed in Finland. And this week's winners are... They are all winners, and they get their benefit money. Next week, new numbers, and remember, even you can win.
Tonight on the Frank Papa Show, historic events of the week, news of tomorrow, weather forecast, and of course, modern jazz.
Thank you. Now let's start with the news. Today the headlines are Finland and EC, dramatic tax hike, scandal in China, and I'm sorry to say, sex. Ho! whole week in just 3 minutes. Take it away, Joe!
Historic events of the week. Give us 3 minutes and we'll give you the world.
Good evening. My name is Joseph Volmont, and this is the FBS News. The Finnish government decides to apply for EC membership in March. However, Finland emphasizes that the EC must only benefit Finland. It mustn't cost us anything, and Finland won't accept any refugees, and Finland's overpriced agriculture must be subsidized. I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship. The American election circus rocks on. This time, the man caught with his pants down is Democrat Paul Brook. The voters are beginning to suspect that there is a strange connection between politics in the U.S. and a compulsive desire to have sex. The next U.S. president will be elected in November. God bless the rest of the world. The Finnish government decides to end the worst depression in its history by raising taxes, a move defying all economic expertise. After this tax hike, the goal will be achieved. Finland has the highest taxes in Europe. The ex-film star, ex-drunk, the most beautiful woman on the earth, Elizabeth Taylor, celebrates her 60th birthday with her husband, an ex-drunk, ex-construction worker, in Disneyland. Where else? According to the American Pulitzer Prize winner, Harrison Salisbury, the former Chinese leader, Mao Zedong, made his most important decisions while on drugs and sedatives, stoned out of his mind. Salisbury says Chairman Mao was totally dependent on sleeping pills and he could take a whole bottle of them each day. Drug abuse among Finnish leaders of that era was out of the question, as they were drunk all the time. And as we all know, booze and pills don't mix. Famine in Russia and the Baltics gets worse. Russian experts fear violent food riots and hundreds of thousands of hunger refugees flooding the Finnish borders. Finland helps her famine-ridden neighbor by sending 30,000 pairs of used glasses to Estonia. Among them, designer glasses. And we'll close with a piece of public relations at its best. The Finnish opera, Kullervo, had its world premiere in Los Angeles. The Finnish government celebrates the occasion by using the taxpayers' money to fly in critics from all over the world. The critics said the opera was pompous, pretentious, chaotic, and ear-piercing. Previously, the Finnish government has invited foreign journalists to Finland to report on the real Finland. They thought Finland was cold, boring, and the reindeer had a radioactive glow. So, if you would like to attack Finland, just contact the Finnish government and they will take care of the expenses. That was the world in late February. Tomorrow, it will be part of history. I'm Joseph Bobbitt for FBS News, and I have a lovely voice.
Historic events of the week. Give us 3 minutes, and we'll give you the world.
Thank you, Joe! Thank you! What a week! But now, let's take a look at the famous Frank Papa files. This week, I shall present to you a film shot by a roommate in a Toronto hotel. John and Yoko are ready for the legendary press conference. The year is 1969, and after that, we make food. But this is rock and roll history.
Imagine there's no people. Imagine all the people.
Rest in peace, John. And our guest in this week's Food and Philosophy is Jesus. Welcome to Frank Papa Show.
Oh, thank you, Frank.
This week, Jesus and I will be preparing some light Easter dishes. What do we got today?
Now, first, we're going to prepare a salad, and as a main course, a kidney stew a la Santa Fe.
A la Santa Fe, it's some kind of Mexican way.
Yes. You know, nowadays, this Mexican kind of stuff seems to be very hot all over Europe.
Mmm.
yes. And isn't Easter a time for fasting?
Oh,
you don't eat much.
No, to be quite frank, I don't believe in fasting at all. I've been around so long that I know that people should and they have to eat properly.
And now the main dish, you put kidneys in?
Oh, yes, we have kidneys here, of course. And, you know, to prepare the kidneys, we first anoint them with this mixture of lemon, licorice, and olive oil. By the way, you know, me and my buddies, we call this the last rites.
The last rites, that's the way you do it, yeah. It was here. Yeah, this reminds me, what do you think about the abortion scandal in Ireland?
Oh, I've been asked about that a lot lately. You know, my old man, he created man and a woman as his equals in some kind of a funny way. And I think that no government can decide what a man can do and what a man cannot do. Let's have some onion in there.
A message to Ireland. Do you feel his sweet?
Yes, if you give me the knife, please.
Yes.
Okay, some red peppers in there, like that. Okay, there you go. Some zucchini.
Zucchini. And what about tomatoes?
Tomatoes, of course, Frank. Thank you.
And what about eggs?
No. I don't recommend eggs. You know, they make it too runny, and anyway, it will lose its taste.
Yeah. And the garnish?
To garnish some laurel leaves, and you have that one.
Sorry, brother. You can still use it all once here.
Oh,
try
yeah.
These.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, sir. I will take them after
yes.
This, after the show. Okay.
Okay.
And then some olives.
Olives.
Of course. Of course, the garnish. Kidney stew.
And now the kidneys are ready to go into the oven. How long will it take?
It will take just about 2 hours at 200 centigrade.
200 centigrade? I can hardly wait. But, Jesus, tell me, how does it feel to be on a TV show? Many people might not find it in good taste.
No, I don't feel like that. You know, I'm not a fossil. Back in my younger days, you know, in the real 20s and 30s, I used to speak on the streets and in the market squares. Nowadays, I just take advantage of the modern media. I'm just, you know, a bloke. By the way, did you know that, you know, last week I was a guest on Dame Edna's show?
Dame Edna?
Yeah, see, I've got the sticker here.
You're on Dame Edna, so what's next?
Well, tomorrow I'm supposed to be in Germany. A talk show discussing, you know, neo-Nazism.
Yeah.
Yeah, to be honest, Frank, you know, I think those Germans will never win.
And 200?
200 centigrade for 2 hours.
Yes. Thank you. That was Jesus. What a lovely guy. And next week, my guest in food and philosophy will be Liz Taylor, who will make us dry martinis. And we'll talk about life. But now, let's play some chess! And now, the weather forecast. Take it away, Tommy! A ridge of high pressure is moving slowly from Brussels towards Scandinavia and reaches Sweden and Finland, bringing joy and sunshine to these cold, barren shores. A low-pressure front is building up over Russia, causing hard rain to fall and thunderstorms all over the integrating Europe. But still, today's highs in Europe. Barcelona, plus 19. Dubrovnik, plus 12. Montreux, warming up, almost boiling. And last but not least, Helsinki, minus 45. And remember, you won't catch a cold if your heart is warm. Thank you, Tony.
Thank you, Tony.
There comes a time when we hear a certain call. When the world must come together as one. There are people dying, and it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We are the world. wants to make a brighter day. So let's start giving. Take away.
We're saving our own lives. It's true, we pay for liberty for you and me.
Frank Papa. See me, feel me, but don't miss me, cause I'll be back. Welcome back. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Is Finland going to Europe?
Yeah!
Will Europe come to Finland?
Yeah!
Do you love me?
Yeah!
Now let's get down to business. There are now 12 easy countries, and even more are joining in, like Austria, Sweden, Finland, and even Norway. But will the EC destroy the culture of its members? Well, who gives a shit? But anyway, I'm going to test Austria, Sweden, and Finland. Which country has the strongest culture? And the winner, of course, of our contest, of course, joins the EC. And here are the teams. Team 1 is Sweden, led by King Charles Gustav. Hey, Sanjar! And 10 Austria, led by President Kurt Waldheim. Culture. And number 3 is Finland, led by President Mauno Koivisto. Terve Manu.
Why doesn't he talk?
He never does. And 10, the points will be given by my good friend Boris. Hi, Bo. Bo knows everything. And the first event is folk music of each country. And Sweden begins. Go ahead, Kalle! Wow! And 10, Austria, silence, please! Wow! And 10, Finland! Have I heard this before? Well, the points, please. Oh, thanks, Bo. And we are still even. We are still even. Bo knows music. And the next event is teenagers. What does a typical teenager look like? First Sweden, then Austria, and Finland. And now, Leonard, go. And then, Heinz. And then, Pekka! Oh, that's like my son. Hello, Frank Jr. And may I get the point? Thanks again, Bo. And the last event is traditional food. First comes Sweden with pizza! Pizza absolute, fish herring, an absolute vodka. Oh, Bo, help yourself. Ah, wonderful. And 10 Austria, hopefully something special. Pizza! Walt Hannes made pizza and schlusser, topped with both pisto and Mozart's Googles! A wunderbar good. And last, and also the least, comes Finland with pizza! Pizza Santa Claus, topped with snow, ice and radioactive reindeer meat! Wow! And now, may I get the points, please? Wow! Who the winner is? Bo says, we are all winners! Easy makes us all winners! Sweden, Austria, and even Finland! 1, 2, 3!
News, the news of tomorrow.
News of tomorrow. See me, feel me. Finlandization is here again. Yay! Finland cancels its application for EC membership and joins the Commonwealth of Independent States. All the Nordic countries and Portugal, Italy, and Japan follow. Goodbye, Brussels. Hello, Moscow. Oliver Stone is back in business. His next film is a story about Adolf Hitler. The film is called I Had a Dream. Dustin Hoffman will play the title role and Katrin Grabbe will play Eva Braun. Stone wants to show that deep inside, Hitler was a deeply feeling short man. French Prime Minister Eric Cresson is caught for image manipulation. Yeah. Scientist Clay Bertrand revealed into Grandpapa News there were inserted images in Cresson's PR video, which were meant to improve her cold public image.
And what about Mrs. Cresson then?
Edith Cresson, on the other hand, wants to improve her sex appeal. And she has done this through sex, which I find quite vulgar.
Tits. Ex-President Mikhail Gorbachev gets a job! Yeah! He will host a weekly game show in London. In the Gorbachev show, ex-leaders of Eastern Europe will be playing darts and trying to win a car. The show will be produced by the BBC. The Nordic Council drops its policy on a nuclear-free zone and declares all of Scandinavia an ozone-free zone. Yay! The Council believes that the Kola Peninsula will make the ozone-free zone reality in 10 years. Let the sunshine in. And now, the changes in the global weather. Take it away, Tony. Due to the greenhouse effect and the rapid destruction of the ozone layer, there's a whole lot of shaking going on our dear planet. No more winters in Scandinavia, and no more skiing in the Alps. The polar ice is melting fast. The Caribbean islands, Bangladesh, and the Jersey Islands are flooded. Africa is burning out. Most people in Australia and Latin America get skin cancer and die. The cattle die. Rock and roll dies. The nutrition chain is broken. Famine, migration, plague, war, locusts. Ladies and gentlemen, the news you just saw was the news of tomorrow. They say you cannot predict the future. Well, I could, but together we can change it. We can make it better. Together we can stop polluting Mother Earth. Together we can create a new Europe. A better Europe. A Europe that can give people jobs, give hope to the young, and security to the old. Lift up your eyes unto the skies. The clouds are breaking. The sun comes shining through. What? Oh, it's late. Weekend is here. Let's party like animals. We'll mix an easy drink. And what do we need? We need Finnish vodka, Finlandia vodka. Some Danish beer. And Swedish creativity. Oh, empty bottle. And Austrian wine, of course. And we'll finish it with German sweat. And then some nose jobs. And the drink is ready. Well, let's party! Yeah, what we got? I'm Frank Papa. See me Feel me.
Papa Show ist vor lebendes Publikum Video gebandet.
Ja Harlekinin lopuksi lähdetään vielä Lassen messiin kokkailemaan. Lassen seurassa on tänään Heinolaan asettautunut monitoimimies Stephen Pauls. Ohjelmaan uusia.
No niin, aika alkaa
nyt!
Just noin. Hyvin menee.
Hyvin menee, mutta me...
Joo, jatka. Ei siinä, jos mies auton kantaa, niin ei siinä ole mitään. Ei siinä ole. No niin. No, ei mitään,
ikinä. No, ikinä ajanut.
Et, no niin.